Okay.
हेलो हेलो हेलो। सो गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। विल स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक। वी हैव सीन थ्योरेटिकल पार्ट इन द लास्ट लेक्चर। आई होप यू हैव गॉन थ्रू द गूगल क्लासरूम एंड लेक्चर नोट्स आर ऑलरेडी अपलोडेड ऑन इट। दिस वीडियो लेक्चर्स दैट पर्टिकुलर लिंक इज ऑल्सो I have uploaded, and there are certain practice MCQs that you can solve for your examination. Soon, some MCQ series I'll also upload on it. So we'll go through the next part. We are almost in the finishing part as well. So within few lectures, we will complete the syllabus. So ILD, that is influence line diagram, will see the problems related to it. So there is a diagram given here. There's a beam, and using influence line diagram, determine the shear force and bending moment at section C in simply supported beam subject shown in the figure. So this is the figure wherein there is a simply supported beam, and then there is a point load of this 40 kilonewton. Then there is a UDL of 4 meter. The UDL of 10 kilonewton meter for the span of 4 meter. Then this is a 6 kilonewton point load, and then there is a 80 kilonewton point load. This 40 kilonewton is at the 2 meter from support A. This 60 kilonewton is in the 2 meter from E, while G at the point G we have this 80 kilonewton point load at the distance of 4 meter from support B. So this is the simple beam or a simply supported beam, you can say, and having the total span of 14 meter. Okay, and what we have to do, we have to just go ahead with this influence line diagram, the concept we have seen in the last lecture, and now we'll go ahead with this calculation of influence line diagram, where we have to calculate shear force as well as the bending moment. So shear force and bending moment at the section C. Section C is marked here at this distance. The distance is 4 meter from support A. So this is the particularly problem, and we'll go ahead with basically, first of all, what we have to do, we have to just we know that when there is a simply supported beam, okay, in that case, what is the shear force diagram? If we just consider a point load over there, so if we just consider point load, in that case we should know that what is this, what is the diagram? Diagram is like this, okay, and if we just consider the point load, and considering the point load, we will get this diagram wherein this is the this is equals to 2 by 7. How this is 2 by 7? So we are just considering that where exactly we have to calculate this shear force and bending moment ordinate. Okay, so that we have to consider. So if we just take this part, this is nothing but equals to Z divided by L. What is Z here? So Z is equals to 4, and this L is equals to 14. So 4 divided by 14, so you will get here 2 by 7. Similarly, you will get this total L minus Z divided by L. So this is equals to nothing but L minus Z divided by L. So you got here, this is equals to 4 divided by 14. If we just calculate it, you will get here 2 by 7. Similarly, if we just calculate L minus Z divided by L, so L minus Z equals to 14 minus 4, that is 10, divided by 14. So you will get here 5 by 7. Okay, so that's the ordinate. Once you get these two ordinate, and then what we have to consider, we have to just check at what location our point loads are and where exactly our UDL is located. So once we got this one, then we should know where exactly this is the UDL from D to E. There's a point load at distance F, and there's a point load at distance G. Okay, so once you know, with the help of only you already gone through the mathematics one, okay, you know the mathematics in 11th 12th itself, or even earlier, you know that how to calculate the ordinate using similar triangle theorem. Okay, so this is exactly you can calculate with the help of, once you know that this is the span, total span is 10 meter from C to B, and then there is ordinate of 5 by 7, so you can calculate this one. You can calculate at this location, this is equals to 4 by 7. If you calculate at F, this is going to be 3 by 7. If you calculate at G, it is going to be 2 by 7. It's so simple. Similarly, if you just go with towards point A, so you have only at this location. Why? How we have chosen this location D, C, E, F, G? These are locations exactly as per this beam. Okay, as per this beam, we have not yet calculated using this exact the load. Only What we have to do, we have to just calculate the ordinate. So we have calculated the ordinate. Once you know with the help of this, this is the main ordinate and this is the main ordinate. Once you know this two ordinate, and then you can easily calculate this one and this one, right? And then this one. So now once you know this ordinate, and now from this diagram we can calculate influence line diagram for shear force at C. Okay, so from that you can calculate shear force at C point. So shear force at C point, so this is 40 kilonewton load. Okay, 40 kilonewton load is acting, and have what is the ordinate of it? Ordinate is 1/7. Okay, ordinate is 1/7. So we will make it, since this is in the downward, this is in the downside of this AB, so we can say this is the negative sign is negative. You have to just consider the sign is negative. Then there is a UDL. This is the UDL, 10 kilonewton meter. Okay, this is the which we have calculated for this. Then this is to be calculated for this one. Now we know that UDL is acting, okay, from D to E. Okay, from D to E. Now we have this 2/7, and this is 5/7. And this is 1/7. So what we will do, actually we will make the simply this area. Okay, what is the area of this? So area will be equals to this 10 multiplied by this 1/2, then 1/7 plus 2/7. Okay, 1/7 plus 2/7. And then multiplied by 2. The distance between C and D is 2 meter. That's how it's very simple one. Again, the next part is 60 kilonewton. Okay, 60 kilonewton. Okay, before that, then this was the part for this location. Now we have to calculate for this location. So for this, it is this part. So again, the same formula is that 10 into 1/2, okay, into distance is 2, and in between. Now in between, this is 5/7 plus 4/7. How it is come? This is 5/7 and this is 4/7. That's it. So that is the related to UDL. So we have converted UDL in two forms. This is the first part, and then this is the second part. Why? Because this is the first part and this is the second part as per this influence line diagram. Now next is 60 kilonewton load. What is the ordinate here? Just multiply this load with the ordinate. What is the ordinate? 3/7. That's it. Similarly, 80 kilonewton. For 80 kilonewton, so 60 kilonewton, I'll mark this one. This is the 60 into 3/7, and then 80 into 2/7. Why 2/7? Because the ordinate is 2/7. That's it. Now if you calculate this total part, so you will get FC is equals to 51.43 kilonewton. So that's it. You will get the shear force as 51.43 kilonewton. So what we have done, first of all, what you have to do, you have to calculate. You have to just check what is the loading, what are the different loading, and where exactly you want to calculate this shear force. Okay, now accordingly, for that purpose, what you will do, you will calculate this influence line diagram. You will draw this influence line diagram. So you will calculate this is the main Z by L, and this is L minus Z by L. So that's it. These two ordinate, once you get, so you can easily calculate this ordinate, this ordinate, this ordinate, and this ordinate. Now, once you calculate that, what you have to do? You have to simply go through the external loading, and multiply it by its ordinate. External loading multiplied by its ordinate. External loading multiplied by ordinate, multiplied by ordinate, multiplied by ordinate. So that's how this shear force has been calculated using influence line diagram. Now we have to also calculate bending moment. So what we will do, you know that for simply supported beam subjected to unit load, there is the diagram that is equals to like this, the triangular pattern, because we want to calculate at C, and that's how you will get influence line diagram for bending moment at C. That this is the same diagram. Diagram is not going to change. Now, so what is the maximum ordinate? So maximum ordinate for this bending moment at C, which is equals to this is Z into L minus Z divided by L. So that's the formula we have seen in the last lecture. So Z into L minus Z divided by L. So if you calculate Z is 4, so L is 14 minus 4 divided by 14. So you will get around 20 by 7. Now the same case, once you get this as 20 by 7, so you can easily calculate this ordinate using the triangular, using this triangle, and using this triangle. So once you know that, you can easily calculate this y1 equals to 10 by 7. This is equals to 10 divided by 7. Then y2, this is equals to 16 by 7. So this is 16 by 7. And just remember, this is if this is 20 by 7, according to span, you should get this is half. And then accordingly, it should go on decreasing. So 20, then 16. Okay, then you got here y3 as 12 by 7 and y4 as 8 by 7. So this is 12 by 7 and then 8 by 7. So once you got, so what you have to do, we have to simply calculate the ordinates. Okay, these ordinates you have already calculated according to the triangular the theorem you have already in the calculated in this school. Okay, so we are not doing anything new here. Just the procedure is new. We have to just go through this diagram, then you have to go through the ordinate, and then we will calculate moment at point C. So how to calculate moment at point C? It is the same. We are not doing anything again new. So 40, 40 is the external load. This is 40 is the external load multiplied by the ordinate. So we are just multiplying by the ordinate 10 by 7. Then again 10 into 1 by 2. 10 into 1 by 2. Now we will just simply, now this, there is no any negative sign or positive sign, right? Since there is no any negative sign or positive sign, what we will do, we will simply make it, add it. No problem here. 10 by 7, 20 by 7, and 16 by 7. So 10 by 7, then 10 by 7 and 20 by 7, this was the first one. Then 20 by 7 and 16 by 7, this is the another one. Okay, this is the first one. For this we will do, and this is the second one. This is what we will do. So we have simply added this part. Even you can do this differently. Then multiplied by 2, and then external loading, that is 60. This is 60 multiplied by ordinate 12 by 7. Then external load 80 into 8 by 7. So this is 8 by 7. And just calculate it. Yes, you will get this is 345.71 kilonewton meter. So that's the calculation of shear force and bending moment according to influence line diagram. According to the influence line diagram, and if you know this diagram, if you know this diagram, that's it. This is the main part, and then rest is very simple one. External loading multiplied by ordinate You know how to calculate the ordinate? So now let us take another problem. A simply supported beam has a span of 15 meter, UDL, uniformly distributed load of 40 kilonewton per meter and 5 meter long, crosses the girder from left to right. So we have seen influence line diagram is nothing but used for if suppose there is a bridge on a river. In that case, suppose a vehicle is moving from one end to another end. So just consider that that's the vehicle having the load of 40 kilonewton per meter and the span of 5 meter. It is moving from left to right. It is moving from left to right. So now for this case, draw influence line diagram for shear force and bending moment at section 6 meter at this location from left end. Now use these diagrams to calculate the maximum shear force and bending moment at this section. So here what we have to do, here you have to consider this UDL which is moving from one end to another end, and you have to calculate this shear force and bending moment at this section which is located at the 6 meter. So first of all, what we will calculate, we will again calculate the same case. Okay, we'll again calculate the same way. Now, earlier, now you need to just consider what is the difference between this problem and what is the difference between this problem. It was this external load were exactly at this position, at this position, at this position. Okay. But now, in this case, this external loading is moving from one end to another end. So what is, in that case, what we should do? So first of all, you know that you have to calculate shear force. Again, you have to calculate bending moment. So shear force and bending moment you have to calculate. Okay, in that case, you have to first of all go ahead with the shear force. This particularly ILD for shear force and ILD for this moment. So first of all, what we will do? So we will do first of all, calculate this ordinate. How to calculate the ordinate? Z divided by L. So this is Z is 6 and L is 15. So that is equals to 0.4. Z divided by L, which is equals to 0.4. Similarly, L minus Z divided by L. So remaining, even if you just calculate this one, so it is very simple that we are going to consider point load and 1 minus 0.4, so you will get 0.6. And if you check it with L minus Z by L, so L is total 15 minus 6 divided by 15. So you will get here 0.6. So that's the ordinate, okay? Similarly, you can even do for the moment. So once we do it, ILD ordinate just to the right of C, that is equals to 0.6. Okay. So this is what we will get. Now, the next part, what we are considering, suppose this at point C, negative shear force is maximum when the head of load touches C. So at this point, tail of the UDL is at a distance of 1 meter from A point. So suppose this is the UDL which is exactly at this point. Okay, so mark again. So you are considering this UDL, this head at this point, and this would be at this point 5 meters, so 1 meter from this A part. So in that case, you have to consider this one. So this is UDL. Okay, this is UDL of 5 meter. Okay, and this is what at this position, again, you have to calculate the ordinate. So ordinate would be with the help of this triangular pattern. So this is going to be 0.667. Sorry. This is actually 0.0667. Okay. This is equals to 0.0667. Now, once you know the ordinate, so what you have to do, you have to simply multiply it by the external load. So you know the formula, 1/2 multiplied by the load, external load. What is external load? Is 40 kilonewton per meter. And then this is 0.0667 plus 0.4, okay, and multiplied by the distance is 5 meter. So if you calculate it, 46.667 kilonewton. So here, what there is only one trick you need to remember. What is the trick? Trick is this, that this UDL is moving from this to this location, from A towards B. Now in that case, you consider that head of this is at this position, just like here, and then the tail of it at this location. So for this, what you get the ordinate. Once you get the ordinate, calculate the shear force, and this is the shear force calculation. So that is the negative maximum shear force. Okay, this is the negative maximum shear force. So FC value is actually -46.667. Similarly, you have to also calculate the maximum positive shear force. So how to calculate maximum shear force? Now in this case, what you have to consider is that this particularly UDL is now the head at this location and tail at this location. So that is the 5 meter. The distance is 5 meters. So at this point, what is the ordinate? So first of all, we will calculate the ordinate. Ordinate would be this is this total distance. Okay, this is actually total distance is 15. 15 minus this 6, you got your 9. Okay, so 4/9 multiplied by 0.6, you will get here 0.267. So this is 0.267. Always remember that this is the maximum value and this goes on decreasing. This is the maximum value, this goes on decreasing. 0.267. Now again, the same way, you got here 0.267. okay, multiply by 40, then 0.6 and plus 0.267 divided by 2 and multiplied by the span, that is 5 meter. Now if you calculate it, 86.67. So that is how you will get the maximum positive shear force and you will get the maximum negative shear force. Now, so that's about the shear force, and the same way you have to calculate for the moment. Now how to calculate it for the moment? So we have to again check that this is going to be, this 5 meter is going to be over this span. This span where exactly we want to calculate at this location. This is the location. So we are going to consider this UDL is on this span. So ILD for moment at point C is going to be, first of all, we will calculate the ordinate Z into L minus Z divided by L. So that is going to be 3.6. This formula is same, Z into L minus Z divided by L. So it's so simple. Now for maximum moment, load position should be such that the section divides the load in the same ratio as it divides the span. Okay. So what we will do, so the section divides the load in the same ratio as it divides the span. So accordingly, we have to calculate here what should be the y1 and what should be the yc, and what should be the y2. Okay, y1 we got, yc already we got, and now we have to calculate y1 and y2. So how to calculate that? For y1, we are going to consider this x divided by 5 minus x equals to 6 divided by 9. So x divided by 5 minus x, this equals to x divided by 5 minus x, and that is equals to this total distance is 6 at one at left end, and at the right end you have got here 9. Total distance is 15. So just like the triangular one pattern, you will get here x. From x you will get here 2 meter. Now once you got here 2 meter, x is 2 meter. That's it. Now what you want, do not know at this position y1 and y2. So we actually calculate here x. This is equals to 2 meter. Now once you got this, this is 2 meter, this is going to be 3 meter, because this 5 minus you will get here 3 meters. So for this distance, you can easily calculate this ordinate. You can easily calculate this ordinate because you know this ordinate. So y1 is going to be 2.4. Okay. And y2 is going to be the same. Why? Because we are considering the same ratio. So this is y1 is 2.4, y2 is also 2.4. Now you have to calculate maximum moment. So maximum moment, you know that how to calculate the maximum moment. Area of ILD for moment at point C under the loaded length. So total UDL is 40. Okay. Now 1 by 2 multiplied by, this is 2.4. And this is also 2.4. Okay, but this distance is 2 meter and this distance is 3 meter. So this is 2.4 plus 3.6 divided by 2 into 2. Again, okay, this is again plus actually. So 2.4 plus 3.6 divided by 2 multiplied by 3 here. And accordingly, you can calculate this is the maximum value of the moment, 600 kilonewton meter. So it is the variation problem, have the variation. In earlier problem, what we have done, we have calculated for the loading, that external loading was exactly at that position, at this position. But in the second problem, it was moving, the point load was moving from one end to another end. But this ILD, influence line diagram, is same. Influence line diagram is same for shear force and moment. Just calculate the ordinate with the help of this formula. Okay. Calculate this ordinate here, calculate this ordinate. And once you calculate at this ordinate, then you can easily calculate the other ordinate. If you got the other ordinate, just multiply it by the loading pattern. So whenever there is a UDL, then if there is a UDL, in that case, this is the part you have to consider to calculate the shear force or even to calculate the moment. So that's how this influence line diagram problems are to be solved. Okay, so we'll stop here. If you are not typed your roll number and name in the chat box, so do it now. And if you are done, you can leave the meeting. We will see the next part in the next lecture. Thank you.